Yeah, grand rising, Big E Astrology. How you doing? It's December 11th. Make it happen Monday. And yes, I finally made it happen. Today, live, ahora, BigEAstrology.com. It's live and available. Still got a big tiny one, you know, one or two little adjustments, terms of services, and one little edit. But it's up, it's live, you can book services, you can email me to sign up for my mailing list and my eisms, my positive little nuggets, also for Coffee Talk, which is December 16th. Enjoy videos, learn about all my products and services, and I'm just very excited. So, we got the new moon tomorrow night. It'll be at 6:31 p.m. Eastern. And at 9 p.m. Eastern, I have my 12-12 portal event. Please come. It's only $12, 72 minutes over Zoom, a special Coffee Talk event. And we'll be discussing the Sagittarius new moon, the energy around it, the last new moon of the year, right? And you do know the real new year is March 21st for the spring equinox. But the collective vibrates on 2024, January 1st. And so this new moon event, we're going to have a sound bowl meditation from my amazing wife, owner and founder of Sabale Pure, Alana Taylor. We're going to discuss the 12-12 portal energy, look at the birth chart of the Sagittarius new moon, and really prepare you for this universal 8-year of 2024. So come with your notepads and pens or pencils. I'm going to give you some things to write down to really set the new beginning and new intentions. And, you know, this moon will be in a square to Neptune and a conjunction to Mars. And today, let's focus on today, Monday, the day of the moon. The moon's in Sagittarius. And 12 Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific at 3 degrees. So it's making a square to Saturn today. And as the moon traps Saturn in Pisces, and as it travels along, it's going to be tonight and early tomorrow morning in a conjunction to Mars. So just watch the emotions, the ideologies, the arguments, the beliefs. You know, things could be a little irritable, you know, in terms of even planning trips, vacations, tickets. Oh, that's too expensive. I'm not doing this. And oh, this person said that and da 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 da. Just be mindful and really kind of set the positive intention getting ready for tomorrow for this new moon event. And I hope you sign up. Just email me directly, bigeastrology@gmail.com. To book the 12-12 portal event, only $12, and Coffee Talk this Saturday, December 12th, 1 p.m. Eastern, looking at the USA Election Day chart. You don't want to miss that. $20, 2 hours, okay? We're going to get to the chart. This was a rough weekend, the Scorpio moon, and my friend lost a friend. One of his friends passed away in an accident. Very tragic, kind of hit the whole community here where we live in Arizona. A young lady died. So prayers to her and her family, and just devastating. In a kind of like a car type of accident event, flip over of a vehicle and stuff. So very emotional for my son, my family and stuff like that. So that was, you know, Friday night, Saturday morning. So that's Scorpio moon, the balsamic moon. And today we're dealing with the dark moon right before we get the new moon, okay? So let's be optimistic today. Let's look at the chart and we'll get into the astro weather. And I hope I hear from you, right? You can do Cash App, $T2UC, right? Or PayPal as a friend. Tailored to you, coaching@gmail.com. If you want to come to the 12-12 portal event tomorrow night, 9 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Pacific. It is going to be a stone groove. What is that? 7 Mountain and 8 Central. See, I'm giving you all the time zones. You don't want to miss it. It's only $12. It's going to be a blast. Let's get to the chart for the Astro Weather for Monday. Monday. Oh, and happy birthday to my friend, my wife's good friend, Nicole. Happy birthday, lady. Sagittarius season. And the Sagittarius birth chart sales going to December 22nd. Sun, moon, and rising. Natal, solar return, or secondary progression chart, $100, 60 minutes over Zoom, or the big shebang, the mini movie of your life, normally $260, only $200. That's a big sale. Natal, solar, or secondary progression. And that's a mini movie of your life, custom video summary, 40 to 50 minutes, audio transit recording of current and future transits, plus videos of your planetary placements, which you get in both services. All right, let's get to the chart. December 11th, Astro Weather. Pew! All right, we're not looking at a particular ascendant. This is 12 noon on the east side for December 11th, and there we go. Boom, right away, Sagittarius moon, okay? So it will finish up tonight at around 9 degrees on the east coast, 10 on the west coast. So it'll be in that conjunction, and still in a conjunction as you're waking up tomorrow. Remember, the new moon is tomorrow at 6:31 p.m. Eastern. That's 3:31 in the afternoon Pacific. And the 12-12 portal event is 9 p.m. Eastern over Zoom, okay? So email me today. I want you to come. All right, so Mercury's moving along, 8 degrees. We still have the Venus, okay, in Scorpio. So this is opposing Jupiter, right? And it's been like that this weekend. And, you know, that brings challenges. We see the nodes, okay, kind of moving along slowly, and they're not really squaring Pluto anymore. You see the Pluto's at 28 degrees. You may feel the vibration a little bit, but the moon squaring Saturn, Sagittarius to Pisces. So there could be some restrictions with your movement, your body, your, you know, you want to sign up for a course or find out, you know, even studying for finals in high school and college. There could be some delays. I think this tells me in general, with the moon square Saturn, you know, there could be some blockages with mom, you know, things like that. And you see here, we're still dealing at the 23 degrees to 28. So it's a 5 degree orb. So you still may feel the Aries north node squaring the Pluto Capricorn, right? And opposing the Libra south node. Definitely a lot of karma going on with the politics and the systems right now. The Jupiter at 6 degrees and the Uranus has now moved to 19 degrees, okay? So that's where you're going to feel tomorrow the in conjunction, the quincunx between Uranus and the Sag moon and sun at 20 degrees, okay? So tomorrow starts the third decan. So just so you understand, this new moon event is in the Sag, Sag Leo Deacon. Okay. So it's definitely more about attention, creativity, expression. This is a very expressive moon. And what's ironic about this all happening, right, is you see that we have the true black moon Lilith in Leo. Okay. And you know, that's pretty fascinating. Okay. So let's just be mindful. I don't have it on this chart, but the Juno's still in Virgo. But let's be mindful with this Lilith in Leo. We're checking in with our heart chakra. How are we vibrating from our hearts, right? The moon square Saturn, it's still saying, you know what? Your emotional mind, where you can find to break through the veils and blockages is through the spiritual discipline. And it's asking you to be responsible and disciplined, right? Watch, you know, Sagittarius can be arrogant and blunt. Watch your mouth, watch your tongue, watch your words, your ideologies, your beliefs, your philosophies. Don't push what you think on others. You know, this is kind of restricting that. So, but, you know, maybe it's asking you be a little bit more compassionate and empathetic before you get blunt and bold and arrogant, okay? And, you know, we still have the Neptune, which is slowly moving direct. Chiron at 15 degrees. So today, Monday, is really preparing us for this new moon. You know, the Mercury and you have the Mercury Venus sextile, and we're still dealing with the Jupiter trine Mercury energy. All right. So there's still a lot of things about trying to ground your logical mind with your expansive mind, right? And this ruler of this Sagittarius new moon tomorrow evening is Jupiter, and Jupiter's in Taurus. So it's really about kind of not just spiritual integrity, ideologies and beliefs, but what do you value? And can we share material items and food and resources, right, to those in need in Gaza or anywhere in the world, the Congo, Sudan, you know, because Jupiter in Taurus, it's trying to really get you to expand your biology and finance and expansion and higher knowledge around things of the earth, material items, your five senses, you know, money itself, but resources, survival. Some people right now are just trying to survive. So love and prayers and compassion, all right? So just be mindful that obviously the Mercury is going retrograde, okay? And this is going to be on the 13th. So right after this new moon energy, the retrograde begins at 8 degrees. And then December 22nd, we'll go back into Sagittarius. And it's retrograde until January 1st, 2023, okay? So when it gets back to Sagittarius, this Mercury, it is going to really kind of get back to integrating in this square to Neptune and a conjunction of Mars. And that's where December 22nd to about the 26th, maybe even 27th, you'll feel it. Things can be kind of dreamy, arguments around spirituality, compassion, religion. Like it's going to be a challenging time. So let's just be patient and consider one another. And, you know, have some agree to disagree, okay? So enjoy the Sag moon today. You know, definitely I would say it can be kind of optimistic. But Sag moon is about the law, beliefs, philosophies. I this is the right way to do it. So you're going to hear a lot of that in the media, the news, all that. And turn off the television. It's not beneficial. Try to get into your root chakra in your body. And we're going to do this tomorrow in terms of, you know, bringing things into practical reality with this new moon energy. And we're going to need to do that, especially with this moon in a square at 20 degrees to Neptune. Okay. Where we sometimes may be a little, you know, in a fog and delusional about certain things. And we've got to kind of bring it into Jupiter Taurus, our physical bodies, right? Speak it through the throat chakra. All right, that's the Astro Weather for Make It Happen Monday. Big E Astrology, BigEAstrology.com. So that's the Astro Weather for December 11th. Pew! All right, wrapping up. Well, I got to tell you, I'm really excited. Not only do I have my 12-12 portal event tomorrow night with my wife, and we already got people signed up. So sign up, BigEAstrology@gmail.com. The website's up and rocking, BigEAstrology.com. And my new podcast interview with Miss Amy Robeson. So check out Amy Robeson on YouTube, right? And she's amazing, does the Akashic Records and just so many different healing modalities. You know, she's into yoga, DNA activation. The interview is about, you know, kind of the spiritual awakening in the age of Aquarius. So on my page, you can find it under interviews and media in my playlist at Big E Astrology on YouTube. But go check out Amy Robeson and see yours truly in an amazing interview, breaking down astrology, but what's going on, some insights for 2024. I'm really excited. And tonight, episode 177, Knowledge is Love. Little kind of talking about the current energy and the astro weather, but I'm going to be talking about the generation from 71 to 83, maybe a little bit of 84, but mainly 83, Neptune and Sagittarius. So a lot of my friends and my wife and a lot of people I know have this energy. So you may have early millennials that may have this. but you have the late Gen Xers, a lot of Pluto Libra people have this placement. Neptune in Sagittarius. We'll talk about it, and that will kind of wrap up everything for Sagittarius season. And then my next podcast, Knowledge is Love, we'll be looking at the cusp of prophecy, the Sagittarius Capricorn cusp, and December 22nd, right, as we start Capricorn season, I will have on Debbie Solaris, the galactic historian, as I call it, the galactic guru, as we talk about the galactic and energies and aliens and different thoughts for 2024. So yeah, come check me out tomorrow night and sign up for the 12/12 portal. Enjoy the Sagittarius new moon tomorrow. Come to the 12/12 portal event, and Monday today, December 11th, the Sagittarius moon, which will be with us, what? Monday, Tuesday, and un poquito, a little bit of Wednesday morning. All right, Eric Taylor, Biggie Astrology, BigEAstrology.com. Have a wonderful, wonderful Monday, the Sagittarius moon. Astro weather, peace.
The moon is connected to my emotion. The moon is connected to